His heads are bowed. Lord, thank you for the privilege and the honor of Sunday morning worship. Thank you for allowing us just to spend time with you. And Lord, our need is you, our want is you. And I'm thankful, Lord, that we have history. History that shows us your amazingness. History that shows us how good you are, and that even in the middle of the darkest dark, that you are the light, you are the hope, you are the provision, you are the miracle, you are our way maker. So Lord, today we come. We come needy. We come just wanting to spend time with you in your presence, in your house. We come. Bless this time. Send you with you. That's our cry in Jesus' name. Sing this to him.
Keep the light in the darkness, my God, that is. never stop working. Never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. Never stop, never stop working. Never stop, never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. Never stop, never stop.
Moments on our journey this year, if you would,
to looking at chapter 3, because I think it's just an explosion of faith. It's a desire of his heart, where he's just crying out to God, worshiping God. It's an actual worship song. We'll see that in just a moment. And as we see this, I want you to think of it from this standpoint. How many of us know that there's going to be times, and maybe we've already experienced that, and if you haven't, you will. There will be time, a time in your life, many times in your life, many times this year, that things will happen and you will not understand them. Things will happen and they will not make sense to you. You won't understand them. You look at it and you're like, I can't figure this out. I do not understand. And you know, we try, I'm guilty of it, try to figure things out. And only to realize that we're not God, come on. And he is. Realize his ways are not my ways. Realize that I can't, with this pea brain, figure him out in any way, form, or fashion. Come on. But I'm going to try. And I'm not going to understand, and I'm not going to, you know, in the trying to figure it out, I can't figure it out. I don't understand it. And so when the understanding is not there, it has to be a complete faith picture. Come on. You just have to trust him. Even when it doesn't make sense, even when you don't understand it, even when it just seems like, you know, this is not the right way, and God's like, let me be God here. Let me run this show. Let me do this. And so there's going to be times of not understanding. There's going to be times of questioning, if we would. If you look back in chapter 2, in verse number 4, it says, behold, the proud, his soul is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. Our lives, my life, and God, it should be defined by my trust in God. In other words, people ought to see me, no matter what Ken's facing, no matter what OQ's facing, no matter what we as a people of God are facing, our life is defined by the fact that we trust our God. That we trust our God even when we don't fully understand it, even when we can't figure out what he's doing, we trust him. We trust him. And you say, how do I do that, preacher? I'm not exactly sure how. Huh? I'm not exactly sure how. You get your truck fixed?
Yes, sir.
You drove in this morning. Huh? Turned it over to the Lord and it got fixed. Amen. But this morning when you got in your truck, you did what? You stuck that key in there and you turned that switch thinking that truck is fixing the crime. Now, turning that switch causes a spark from the ignition, causes a spark. I can't even begin to try to tell you what all is fixing to happen when he turns that key. Especially in today's vehicles, because it's probably got to go through a computer chip, and then it's got to be told by that computer to fire this particular spark plug that's going to ignite this particular gas amount inside that piston chamber. It's going to cause that motor to come alive. I don't know how it works, but I turn the key. I don't know how it works, but I trust that when I put the key in, if that battery's not dead, come on, that it's going to fire up. I don't know how that works. You see, guys, there's things that when we don't know how they work, but we what? Hell yeah. We trust them. We turn the key. If you didn't trust it, you wouldn't put it in there. If you didn't trust it, you wouldn't have been wasting the energy to walk out there. But you trusted it, and you turned that key on, and it fired right up. There's all kind of things that I'm not exactly sure how they work. yet they do. Yet they do. You see, guys, here's the truth. We don't need to be able to completely understand something to have faith in. But what I have is belief. I have to have a belief that trusts my God. And that is so important. Because the Bible says, if we go back up and look in chapter 2 and verse 4, that the just shall live by his faith. It's hard for me to live by my faith in God unless I trust my God. And I believe my God can, no matter what it is, no matter what is thrown at me, no matter what I'm facing, no matter if I can figure it out or not, no matter if it makes sense to me or not, or not, that my God can. Come on. I have to believe that. I have to believe that if I'm going to move forward. Because there's going to be those times when it doesn't make sense. There's going to be those times when I will question. In chapter 3, begin reading with me in verse 1. And notice what it says. It says, a prayer of Habakkuk, the prophet, on y'all say that. Shiganoff. Say it three times fast. Say amen. A prayer on Shiganoff. Now let's stop there just a minute. Notice what it says. It says it's a prayer that Habakkuk's praying. And it's an important prayer. And it's a prayer that you're going to see comes from his heart, comes from his need, comes from his, you know, his desire for God to intervene and God to move and God to bless. You're going to see this in his prayer. He's going to request some things. And requesting is part of prayer. But I also want you to see that as he's crying out to God and asking God, you know, Jesus, when he gave us that model prayer, he said, here's what you do. When you pray, he said, you cry out to God and you say, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day. It's okay to request. Amen. It's okay to ask. You saw that last week. And so Habakkuk's going to ask, and he's going to request, but he's also going to remember. He's going to remember the greatness and the goodness of God. He's going to remember the mercies and the provision of God. You see, when you're crying out to God as he is, you'll see that he's asking, but he's also remembering. And he's also responding. Responding. And so, when I looked up that word, Shiganoff, and that word, they really don't know the meaning of it, other than it was most likely it's a musical term, and so most likely this is what you're going to see is kind of a worship song that he's crying out from his heart, and so it was intended to help. It was intended, and so Habakkuk's cried out to God. And so we'll pick up now verse 2. I'm sorry, I didn't give that to you. Oh Lord, he says, I've heard your speech and was afraid. Oh Lord, revive your work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make it known in wrath. Remember mercy. There's three requests right there. Revive your work. Make it known, God. Remember mercy. He's asking for mercy. He's asking for God to move and for God to bless and for God to do amazing. And he's like, and basically, I love this. He's like, God, I've heard this. I've heard it. I've heard what you've done. I've heard how you've moved and how you've blessed and how you've saved and how you grew and how you did amazing. God, I heard it. Basically, guys, here's what he's saying. God, I ask you to do it again. I'm amazed at what you've done, God. And God, I ask you to do it again. Keep reading. So God came from Teman, the Holy One from Mount Paran.
His glory covered the heavens, and the earth was full of His praise. His brightness was like the light, and He had rays flashing from His hand. And there His power was hidden. Before Him went pestilence, and fever followed at His feet. He stood and measured the earth. He looked and startled the nations, and the everlasting mountains were scattered. The perpetual hills bowed. His ways are everlasting. I saw the tents of Cushan in affliction, the curtains of the land of Midian trembled. O Lord, You were displeased with the rivers. Was Your anger against the rivers? Was Your wrath against the sea? That You rode on Your horses, Your chariots of salvation. Your bow was made quite ready. Oaths were sworn over Your arrows. Selah. You divided the earth with rivers. The mountains saw You and trembled. The overflowing of the water passed by. The deep uttered its voice and lifted its hands on high. The sun and moon stood still in their habitation. All the light of Your arrows they went. At the shouting of Your glittering spear, You marched through the land in indignation. You trampled the nations in anger. You went forth for the salvation of Your people, for salvation with Your anointing. You struck the head from the house of the wicked by laying bare from foundation to day. What a bit of break, Sima. You thrust arrows, or you thrust through with His own arrows the head of His villages. They came out like a whirlwind to scatter me. Their rejoicing was like feasting on the poor and sick. You walked through the sea with Your horses, though the heap of the grain. Through the heap of the grain. Now stop there for just a second. Basically what He's saying, God, You brought Your people. And He kind of goes back in history. Aren't you thankful that you have a history saying me? Aren't you thankful that you can look in your past and see His hand? Aren't you thankful that, and that's important, guys, as He's requesting, He's remembering. He's saying, God, I remember when You did this. God, I remember when You did that. God, I remember when Your people were over in Egypt and You set them free. How You did it with plagues and all these different things. How You squashed down Pharaoh when Pharaoh chased after God. I remember what You did there. Aren't you thankful You have a history? Say amen. How that God was able to take and set His people free and deliver His people. And when they went across across the Jordan into the promised land, they went across on what? Dry ground. Waters heaped up. When they crossed that Red Sea, they went across on what? Pharaoh right behind them. Dry ground. Waters heaped up. Why? Because of God's goodness and God's greatness. And He's like, God, I remember. That's so important. Say amen. When you have questions that don't make sense, you need to remember. You need to remember the faithfulness of your God. Come on. You need to remember the goodness of your God. You need to remember the amazingness of your God. Even when it doesn't make sense right now. You know, and go back to a time that didn't make sense then. And then see His goodness. See His faithfulness. See His willingness in your life. And that's exactly what Habakkuk's doing. He's going back in history, guys. I thought about that this morning. I am so thankful that I have a history. That I can go back and remember the goodness of God. Remember the faithfulness of God. Remember the provision of God. Remember the willingness of God to be involved in my life no matter what I faced, no matter what I went through. Remember what God has done. And that's where His focus is. When it doesn't make sense, you focus on what He's already done in your life. Come on. When it doesn't make sense, you remember all that He's done, all that He will. And I love what He says in verse 16, guys. He said, and when I heard, you said, what do you hear, preacher? Everything He just said. I want you to see this. This is cool. He said, when I heard what I
just said, when I heard about His goodness, when I heard about His faithfulness, when I heard about, when I recalled all that in my mind and I spoke it out loud and I heard that with my ears, I love what He said. He said, it caused me to tremble, my body tremble. It blew Him away. It just, I mean, it just got all over Him. But God, not was doing in His situation, come on, but what God had already done, just look. You ever had any of them all moments? You ever had any of them that just, that you know, whatever, maybe something you can go back to in your life? And it just causes you to kind of tremble and shake all over to where your lips quivered at the voice. You know, I mean, it just gets all over you. Let me tell you something, gets all over me. And something I pray will always get all over me. Guys, I'm going to take you back a minute because I remember who I was. I remember where I was going, Brother Lewis. I was hellbound. I remember that. I remember pre-Jesus times. Y'all heard me use that term, pre-Jesus. I remember the stupidity. I remember the rejection of the cross and of Christ and of Jesus and His salvation. I remember that walking that street. I remember making a statement to a buddy of mine, we'll walk through the streets of hell and take names. I remember who I used to be. And praise God He didn't give up on me. Praise God He didn't forgive me. Praise God, He came to my house and through the Holy Spirit convicted me, drew me to Him, broke me down. And when I cried out to Him and begged, I remember what He said, Lord, and He said, come. I remember what He said. He said, I love you and I died for you. I remember what He said. It said, even when I looked at Him, it said, even me, Jesus. And He said, even you can. For whosoever calleth upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But God, I'm dirty. He said, I'll clean you. But God, the Bible says that I'm your enemy. He said, I still love you and I died for you while you were yet a sinner. God, you can really forgive me for being me and all that went with me. He said, I will do that. I want to do that. I will, that no man will perish. You see, that awes me. I pray I never get over the day I got saved. I pray it never means any less to me than that night, that Thursday night, when I cried out to Jesus and I said, Jesus, save me. I'm wicked, I'm wretched, I'm a sinner. I'm stupid and done stupid and messed up. Please save me. And He forced to save me. With mouth confession is made. Man believeth in the heart unto righteousness. I believed in my heart that He was the Son of God. That's a wow moment in my life. Come on. That's a moment in my life when even standing right here today, some 30 years down way in my past, some history, I can go back and I can see that living room so vividly. I can see the two men sitting across from me so vividly. I can go back to that place. And let me tell you, when I go back to that place, I tremble. I go back to that place, I'm amazed. I go back to that place, I'm wow, because He would do that for me. Well, it doesn't make any sense, Miss Bobby. You got to go back to that place of wow and amazement of His provision in your life. And that's exactly what Habakkuk was doing. You know, the Bible says this in the book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 8, that my Jesus is the same today as He was yesterday. Say amen. That's Him. He hadn't changed. That's why I go back. That's why I go back.
And here's truth, guys. It means to me, when I read that verse right there in Hebrews 13, it means to me that what God has done in the past, He can be trusted to do again in the future. So when it doesn't make any sense, when it doesn't make any sense about what's going on, I trust Him. I trust Him. I go back and I see where His faithfulness is unquestionable. His commitment to me is unquestionable. His showing up is unquestionable. Come on. Go back there. Take a moment. Take a moment. because that's true. You go back there and you see who He is. I love what He says in verse 16. And when I heard, my body trembled. My lips quivered at the voice. Rottenness entered my bones. And I trembled in myself. That I might rest in the day of trouble. When He comes up to the people, He will invade them with His troops. I want to show you that in the NIV because I want you to see what He says. I just want to give you one more translation. He said, I heard in my heart pounding. What makes your heart pound? I love that picture. He heard everything He just said about the goodness and the greatness and the awesomeness and the mightiness of God. And he's like, man, my heart's pounding. My lips are quivering. At the sound, the cane cracked in my bones. And my legs, they just tremble. But watch what he said. But I wait. Day of calamity. He says, I'm waiting on God. It's God's time. I don't like to wait. Come on. I'm not a good waiter. My wife says patience is not one of my strong suits. I would say it's probably one of my worst suits. One of the things I struggle with is waiting on Him. And yet I said, you know, I know who He is. I know what He's done. I can trust Him. I can wait. I can wait on Him. I can wait on Him. Even when it doesn't make sense, I can wait. I don't do it well, but I can wait. I can wait. I just have to be careful, hanging in there, to stay faithful. Because so many times when you wait, you want to do what? Help me out. Don't quit. I have to stay faithful. And you know, not just staying faithful, but I gotta watch. I gotta watch for what He's doing. I gotta watch for, you know, I gotta keep my eyes focused on Him. I'm trusting Him. I'm waiting on Him. I'm believing on Him. I'm in the fight. I'm staying faithful. And not only that, I'm looking for Him to do it. I'm waiting on Him. Not Him to fix this. I'm just waiting on Jesus. Come on. And what He's willing to do in my life. And not only that, guys, I'll hang out with Him. Isn't that cool? And He says, you wait on me. You trust me. You've seen what I've done. Come on. You have a history. There's wild moments all in your life. I guarantee we could stay here until tonight talking about wild moments from how He's blessed to save me. We could talk about the amazingness, the healings, the provisions, the taking care of us. When it all seemed hopeless, He pushed it home. So I'm waiting. And while I'm waiting, I'm watching for Him. That's who I'm looking for. I'm looking for Jesus to move in this situation. I'm looking for Him. And you know what's crazy about me? It took me forever to figure this out, and I still, he's waiting with me. He's waiting with me. Two more verses. 17. Though the fig tree may not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, though the labor of the olive may fail and the fields they yield no food, though the flock may be cut off from the fold and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength. He will make my feet like deer's feet and make me walk on my high heels. To the chief musician with any string instrument. Real quick, living by faith means standing tall, even on the smallest signs of hope. Living by faith means finding joy in the midst of pain. Living by faith means finding small blessings in the midst of things being difficult and chaotic and we don't see it or understand. Living by faith means wedging my toes as the deer who's up on the high mountain. You ever seen a mountain goat up there? I love to watch outdoor channels and stuff. Them mountain goats get on them. I don't even know how they stand. I don't know how they got there, but they got there. And not only that, but they're standing there in the midst of just a little ledge. You dig into that little ledge. You hang in there to your God. Your God can. Your God's proven himself over and over and over. And even though when it doesn't make sense, you go back a little bit. You look back at his blessing. You look back at what he's done. Man, let me tell you what it'll do. It'll wow you up. And you'll turn, if it doesn't wow you up some from, come on. If you can't get excited, and that's where he is. He's like, man, it don't matter what happens. Now I gotta praise him. Because I know who he is and I know what he's done for me. Somebody say amen.